Hello everyone. So now we will see how the skewers instrument is look like and what are the parts and then what are the characteristic of it. Okay. So here you can see this type of instrument is known as screw gauge. Okay. So first of all you can see there is a U-shaped metal thing is there and it is connected to this end and this end. This first end is known as stud, and when I'll open this with this end, you can see this has a plane surface. See, this inner part is plane surface and so also this part you can see. So both the openings are having a plane surface. Okay. Next is, as you can see at this end, this screw head is there, which is rotatable. This screw head is known as ratchet, with which we can open this screw head or we can close these two plane surfaces, which are known as studs. So this is one stud and this is the other stud. At this end, it is connected with a cylindrical hub, you can see. This is the cylindrical hub, which is also rotatable with the ratchet. And there is markings of scale, we can see. There is some divisions starting from 0 to 100. There are 100 divisions. And it is placed over a line, which is known as the axis of the cylindrical hub, and there is also graduations are there on this reference line or this axis. This axis or this reference line is known as the pitch scale or linear scale. And on this circular scale, or we can say the cylindrical hub, the graduations are there, which is known as a circular scale, and this is known as the linear scale. And on the circular scale, we can have here in this instrument, we are having 100 divisions, and each of we can say there are 100 equal parts, and here we are having number of divisions each of 1 millimeter in length. And with this two openings, we can use this two opening to measure the thickness of a wire, sheet of paper or glass lamina, etc. Okay, that's all. Next part is, since this is a measuring instrument, there is some characteristics as I said. So now we will discuss all the characteristics. First of all, we will go for the pitch of this instrument. So just let me tell you what is pitch. So basically, a pitch is something which we can say that distance traveled on this linear scale. See, as I said, there are two types of scales. The inner reference line scale, this scale is known as the linear scale. This is actually the linear scale, you can see everyone. And this cylindrical cell is scale is known as the circular scale. So pitch is basically the linear distance traveled by the screw in one complete rotation. Getting my point? Linear distance on this scale, we can see the linear distance traveled by this circular scale. But how linear distance will be measured? That should be measured in one complete rotation. Now suppose, how to know that rotation is complete? So for that, suppose here I am showing you, okay, see, the zero mark of this reference line is coinciding with 80 division on the circular scale. Now when I rotate this scale to close this opening, if it is again coming, okay, it's not going there, so just open it a little bit longer. See, now let me, okay, now see, this is again the reference line is again coinciding with the number 80 division. So now when I am rotating this circular scale, again I am getting 80 here. So now I can say that I have completed one rotation. okay. So if I rotate this further and again I will able to get, no, it's not getting 80. So the division we are starting with, if it is coming again while rotating the circular scale, then we can say that we have completed one rotation. So now, as I said, pitch is defined as the linear distance traveled by the screw in one complete rotation. So how we can define that, I mean how we can determine the value of pitch? Suppose I am giving here, now see, I am opening the screw up to 5 division on the linear scale. Okay, you can see here we are having the 5th division. Okay, now I am closing the screw head up to that and just mark the reference line coinciding with which division. Yes, now it is close to the 5th division and the reading which is coinciding with the reference line is 35. So we will try to rotate. That means we need to close this opening here and we will count how many complete rotations is taking to close this. Okay, so for this thing, let's start. This is 1. This is 2, 3, 4, and done. Okay, so we can see that it takes 4 complete rotation and a half to close this 2 plane surfaces of the stud. So pitch will be defined as the number of division on this linear scale divided by the total number of complete rotation. So that will be 5 millimeter divided by 4 and the value will give us the pitch of this scale. So the volume, the working formula for determination of pitch of this instrument is distance moved by the screw on the linear scale divided by number of rotations given to the screw. Okay, next thing, we can determine the least count of this instrument. Basically, least count is the measurement that can be measured with minimum value, or we can say the least measurement that can measured with the help of this instrument will be known as the least count. Suppose I'm considering about the wall clock or the wristwatch we use. So the least count of that instrument will be 1 second. Okay. Similarly, let us determine the least count of this instrument. So for this thing, we have to understand the working formula for least count is pitch divided by number of complete rotations on the circular scale. So you can see here we are having... Yes, as you can see, there if it is zero now, see, this is a zero mark and it is increasing 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and there are still 10 divisions ahead of 90 to zero. So that means there are 100 divisions on the scale. So we have to divide pitch with 100 so that we can get the least count of this instrument. Okay, clear? Now the last part for the instrument is the error calculation. So due to wear and tear and the arrangement process due to the manufacturing process, we can experience 2 types of error in such instruments. One is zero error and the other one is backlash error. So backlash error is very simple, that is due to the wear and tear, as I said, and the loose fitting of the screws. If the screw is not properly fitted with the instrument or with the ratchet, we can say, and there is some gap is also prevailing even after closing it tightly, then that kind of measurmental error will be known as backlash error. Okay, next thing is important part, zero error. So for that thing, just observe one thing here. Just let me rotate it. Yes, you can see here the zero of the linear scale. Here it is the linear scale and this is the zero of the circular scale. Both are exactly coinciding with each other. Now let me show it to you like this. Yes, you can see. Just let me open it a little bit. Yes, you see. Now see, this zero of this linear scale is exactly coinciding with the zero of the circular scale. But some instruments are still there, just for the, we can say that is screw gauge. In some instruments, this zero on the circular scale, yes, the zero on the circular scale lies ahead of the zero of the linear scale or lies below of the zero mark of the linear scale. So in that cases, we can experience finite values of zero error. So basically, zero error is the error which comes into place if the zero mark of the circular scale is not exactly coinciding with the zero of the pitch scale or the reference line. Okay. Now in this instrument, you can see properly that the zero of the reference line is exactly coinciding with the zero of the circular scale. So in this instrument, we are having no zero error. Okay. Now let me show you another instrument. Yes, this is also a type of another screw gauge, but here you can see, now see, this is the zero of the circular scale, but see, now you can see it, see. The zero of the linear scale is lying at this end. At this point, the zero of the linear scale is there. And the zero of the circular scale is there. Here the zero of the circular scale and here is the zero of the linear scale. So, here we can say the zero of the circular scale is lying behind the zero of the linear scale. So, in this case, the zero error is said to be positive. If in such case, suppose, just let me show it to you. If in such case the zero, it is not closed yet. Okay. So if in such case the zero of the circular scale is lying above the zero mark of the linear scale, in this case, the zero error will be known as negative zero error. Okay. So, before taking observations with this instrument, we have to notice, is there any zero error or not? So, we have to first see whether the reference line, the zero of the linear scale and the zero of the vernier, cylindrical scale or the circular scale, the zero of the linear scale and circular scale are perfectly coinciding with or not. In this case, you can see they are perfectly coinciding. That means, here we are having no zero error or zero zero error. But in this instrument, you can see here, yes. So basically the zero of the linear scale is here. The black mark, you can see it is here. And the zero of the circular scale is lying 5 divisions behind of the linear scale. So it is having positive zero error by 5. If the zero would lie somewhere ahead of the zero of the linear scale, just like this, suppose this will be the case, then in this case, the zero error will be there and it will be of negative zero error. But this can be removed. There is something called zero error correction. For that thing, first of all, we should know the value of zero error. As I said, if the zero of the circular scale is lying ahead of the zero of the linear scale, then that will be taken as negative. But the zero error correction will be positive. Now see, in this case, the zero of the circular scale is lying 5 divisions ahead of the zero of the linear scale. So here, the zero error will be minus 5, but the zero error correction will be plus 5. Okay. Now, if I just show you the actual zero error we have in this instrument, see. I'm sorry, it is not closed. Yes, it is closed now. So see, here we are having the zero, the linear scale division of zero mark of the linear scale, and here we are having the zero of the circular scale. So there is five divisions, or we can say the zero of the circular scale is lying five divisions behind of the zero of the linear scale. So here the zero error will be there, and that will be positive zero error, and the zero error correction in this case will be equal to minus 5. Okay, after knowing the zero error, we have to add this value, the zero error correction, whether it is positive or negative, we have to add this with the observed value of the given specimen. Okay, clear? So yes, that is all about the specifications and the construction of the and the working principle of screw gauge. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now let's see what experiments and what things we can measure using this instrument. Thank you. Hello everyone. So now we're gonna see how to determine the diameter of a wire using a screw gauge. So for this experiment, we require a screw gauge and a wire. So now using these two things, we're gonna determine the diameter of this wire. Okay, so before getting into the observation, we need to determine three things. First thing is determination of pitch of this instrument. Okay, so for this thing, let me give a linear division on the linear scale as, okay, just let me give it to 5 divisions. So yes, it is 5 division. Now you can see at 5 millimeter on the linear scale, we are having 90 division on the circular scale. So we have to close this instrument such that it will cover all the distance, and we have to count the number of complete rotation. Okay, so let's start now. I am moving it. So this is 1. Again 90 is coming up. So this is 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, so it's almost there. So we got 5 complete rotations for 5 millimeter division on the linear scale. So for the pitch part, we can now write, as you can see, so distance moved by the screw is 5 millimeter, and number of full rotation given to the screw is equal to 5. So that is coming as 1 millimeter. So pitch of this screw gauge is 1 millimeter. Next thing, we have to determine the least count, that will be pitch divided by number of divisions on the circular scale. We know for this instrument, we are having 100 divisions on the circular scale. Okay, starting from 0 to 100, right? So for that thing, here I can write it as pitch is 1 millimeter divided by number of divisions is 100. So that is coming as 0.01 millimeter, or that will be equal to 0.001 centimeter. So we can say the least count of the instrument, that is this screw gauge we are using, is equal to 0.001 centimeter. Okay, clear? Next part, we need to determine the zero error of it. So let's see whether our instrument has which kind of zero error. So let me close this first. So as you can see here clearly, that this is the zero mark of the linear scale, and here this is the zero mark of the circular scale, and they are perfectly coinciding with each other. Okay, this is zero of linear scale and this is zero of circular scale. So since the two zero marks are coinciding perfectly with each other, we can say this instrument has no zero error. Okay, so we can write here zero error is equal to no zero error, or that is equal to zero, and zero error correction or zero correction will be equal to zero error into least count, so that will be zero into LC, which is again equal to zero. So this instrument what we are using has zero error, or it has no zero error. Okay, so now let's move to the observation. We just completed the observation part. Now let's move to the tabulation, or how to take the measurements with this instrument. Okay, all of you can see the tabulation for the measurement of diameter of a wire using screw gauge. First of all, we need to find out linear scale reading. That means the number of divisions what we will observe on the linear scale. Next part is circular scale reading. In that, how we can define it? We have to multiply the circular scale division to the least count, and we know that least count of this instrument is 0.01 millimeter. So we have to multiply that with the circular scale division. After that, we can find out the diameter by just adding these two final readings, that is LSR plus CSR. But in this case, we have two observations. One is observed diameter, another is corrected diameter. Observed diameter, what we will calculate it from this, and corrected diameter, that is the diameter which will be found out by adding the zero correction with the observed diameter. But since we are having zero as a zero correction, so what will be the observed diameter? That will be exactly equal to the correct diameter. Okay, so let's start taking observations. Now see, this is the instrument and this is the wire. We have to put this wire in between the two plane surfaces of the studs, and then we have to take the linear scale reading first. So let me put it inside. I'm just holding it in between the studs and rotating the ratchet so that it will hold the wire perfectly. Yes, when you heard this sound, you will be sure that this wire is perfectly held by the instrument or the screw gauge. So now let's observe the linear scale reading. So this is the linear scale, all of you can see, and it is just covering one division on the linear scale. So for this wire, we are having linear scale reading as one. This is a zero mark, okay, and one division is covered by this circular scale. Okay, so linear scale reading will be equal to 1 millimeter. So next part is, what is a circular scale reading? So for that thing, we have to see the circular scale division on the circular scale. That means we have to see this reference line is coinciding with which division of the circular scale. So you can see this is 50 mark, and this is 51 and 52. So you can see the reference line is coinciding with the 52 division of the circular scale. So now I can write the linear scale reading, we can write as 1 millimeter, and the number of circular scale division on reference line, that is small n, is equal to 52. Clear? So the value of circular scale reading, that will be 52 into least count, and we know least count is 0.01 millimeter. So that will be 52 into 0.01, which will be equal to 0.52 millimeter. Okay, clear everyone? Next thing, we have to add the two things. Next, the observed diameter, that will be the sum of linear scale reading and the circular scale reading. So that will be 1 plus 0.52, that will be 1.52 millimeter. And corrected, here D equal to D0 plus C. D0 is the observed diameter and C is the zero correction, which is also equal to 0. So the corrected value of the diameter is also equal to 1.52 millimeter. Okay, so we got our first observation, let it be equal to D1. Now let's take another set of observation. We have to remove this and try to place it at some other place, or try to fix the wire at other place, just as you have placed in the earlier one. Okay, so yes, now it is fixed, you can see. So let's see the linear scale reading first. Yes, you can see this is also equal to 1 division on the linear scale. This is 0 and the 1 division is covered by this circular scale. Next, we have to see the circular scale division on the reference line. So again, this is the 50 division and this is 51, 52, 53. Now you can see. Just observe the lines at eye level so that you will not be confused. So this is coming as 53, all of you can see. See, this line is coming. So this is 51, 2 and 3. So number of circular scale division on the reference line is 53. So linear scale reading is again equal to 1 millimeter. Number of circular scale division is coming as 53. So that will be 53 into 0.01. So that will be 0.53 millimeter. And this will be the sum of these two readings, that is linear scale reading plus circular scale reading. So that will be 1.53 millimeter. And here D2 will be equal to 1.53 plus 0. That will be 1.53 millimeter again. Okay, now let's take another set of observation for this thing. So try to fix, as I said, different places of the wire. The variation will be very less because we are using the same instrument and the same wire again and again. So let's see the first linear scale reading. Yes, all of you can see this. This is also equal to 1 division. And now we just got a different value of circular scale reading. That is, this is 40 and this is coming as 45. 46 division is coinciding with the reference line. Okay. So in this observation, we are getting the linear scale reading as 1 millimeter. And the circular scale reading as 46 millimeter. So 1, this is 46, so this will be 0.46 and this will be 1.46, or we can write D3 will be equal to 1.46 millimeter again. So similarly, we will continue for next two observations. Let me take that in front of you. Now see, I am just trying to fix it. Okay, it is fixed now. So yes, linear scale division is again equal to 1 division and the division on circular scale is also equal to 53 in this case. Okay, so this is equal to 1, this is 53, this will be again 0.53, this will be 1.53. And D4 will also be equal to 1.53. Now let us take the last observation. Okay, so it is fixed. You can see linear scale division is again equal to 1 division on the linear scale and circular scale division is exactly 50. So let us write this thing. So we can write it as 1, this is 50, this will be 0.50 millimeter, this will be 1.50, and here the last D5 will also be equal to 1.50 millimeter. So here we have completed 5 set of observations for the wire. Now we will calculate the mean diameter of the wire. Let it be equal to D, that is equal to the sum of all the 5 observations divided by 5. So that will be equal to 1.52 plus 1.53 plus 1.46 plus 1.53 again plus 1.50 divided by 5. So that will be equal. So the sum will be equal to 7.54 divided by 5. So that will be equal to 1.508 millimeter. And next thing is we have to convert this thing to centimeter. So that will be equal to. So now this will be equal to 0.1508. centimeter. Or finally we can say that the diameter of the given wire is found to be 0.1508 centimeter. Thank you.